Russia has successfully tested Kedr ICBM, developed by the Moscow Institute of Thermal Technology, part of the state space corporation Roscosmos. As reported by a source to Russian news outlet TASS, in mid-June, the latest unique ballistic missile, developed by the Moscow Institute of Thermal Technology, was successfully test-launched from the Plesetsk airport. Viewers may note that the Moscow Institute of Thermal Technology has developed Russia's Topol, Topol-M, Yars, and Bulava ICBMs. According to the source, solid-fuel Kedr ICBMs will replace RS-24 Yars systems at the turn of 2030. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russia is developing new Kedr ICBM to replace RS-24 Yars. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. RS-24 Yars is a Russian, MIRV-equipped, thermonuclear-armed, intercontinental ballistic missile. First tested on May 29, 2007, after a secret military R&D project. It is essentially the same missile as the Mod 1 version, Topol-M, except the payload bus has been modified to carry multiple independently targetable warheads, MIRV. Each missile is thought to be able to carry up to 4 warheads, although there is uncertainty about what the maximum capacity is. The 2007 tests were publicized as a response to the missile shield that the United States was planning to deploy in Europe. RS-24 has been deployed operationally since 2010, with more than 50 launchers operational as of June 2017. Topol-M, from which RS-24 Yars is developed, is itself derived from Topol missile, which is a Soviet-era system. Since the deployment of the RS-24 Yars missile, America, which is the main rival of Russia, has made significant progress when it comes to anti-ballistic missile defense. Two systems developed by the US have an impact on Russian nuclear deterrence. Let's check them one by one. For the protection of the US mainland, GMD, or Ground-Based Mid-Course Defense, has been deployed. GMD anti-ballistic missile system has been developed with an aim to protect against incoming missiles by engaging them during the mid-course phase of ballistic trajectory flight in space. GMD has Ground-Based Interceptor, GBI, which carries an exo-atmospheric kill vehicle, EKV, that's designed to collide with the incoming missile to destroy it. Sensors include ground-based radars, GVR, upgraded early warning radars, forward-based X-band radars, FBXB, such as the sea-based X-band platform, and the ANTPY-2, all developed by Raytheon. While GMD is the only operational system that's available to the US military, which can intercept intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBM, another system is expected to see deployment soon, the SM-3 Block 2A missile. In November last year, during a test, an SM-3 Block 2A missile launched from a USS John Finn DDG-113 successfully destroyed a mock intercontinental ballistic missile ICBM target. U.S. Missile Defense Agency and U.S. Navy said that the test met its primary objective, proving that an SM-3 Block 2A can engage an ICBM threat. U.S. Navy Vice Admiral John Hill, the director of MDA, also said the following in a statement. This was an incredible accomplishment and critical milestone for the Aegis BMD SM-3 Block 2A program. The department is investigating the possibility of augmenting the ground-based mid-course defense system by fielding additional sensors and weapon systems to hedge against unexpected developments in the missile threat. We have demonstrated that an Aegis BMD-equipped vessel, equipped with the SM-3 Block 2A missile, can defeat an ICBM-class target, which is a step in the process of determining its feasibility as part of an architecture for layered defense of the homeland. To mitigate the degradation of nuclear deterrence, a Kedr missile has been conceptualized. Kedr will have mobile and silo-based launchers. It is thought to be a MIRV, or Multiple Independent Reentry Vehicle, capable missile. Kedr will also be able to accommodate multiple decoy payloads to complicate matters for the ballistic missile defense system. It will also be hardened against electronic jamming. The missile will be solid-fueled and will be easier and quicker to launch. A source had earlier revealed to TASS that Russian defense companies had launched engineering drafting work on the Kedr ICBM. As per reports, Kedr ICBMs will replace RS-24 Yars systems at the turn of 2030. RS-24 Yars is a 49,000 kilogram or 108,026-pound missile with a maximum range of 10,500 kilometers or 6,525 miles. Kedr will have a similar range. The nuclear deterrence of a country depends on the nuclear triad. A nuclear triad is the capability to launch nukes from land, air, and sea, and consists of land-launched nuclear missiles, strategic aircraft with nuclear bombs or missiles, and nuclear missile-armed submarines. While Russia has a full-fledged nuclear triad, it will certainly want to keep land and sea-based systems in optimal condition since the Russian bombers are Cold War era and vulnerable. Even when the Kedr ICBMs enter service, it's unlikely to increase the number of weapons that Russia operates. Instead, it will likely continue to be part of the ongoing modernization efforts. The idea is to replace legacy platforms with more modern platforms, which are harder to defend against.